Hello everyone, and let's check out another exciting chess game from the history of chess. In this chess game, white is Wilhelm Steinitz and his opponent is George McDonnell, a respected chess author and a chess player. And this game was played in the Dundee Chess Congress in 1867. And let's check out how this game went on. Wilhelm Steinitz starts the game with playing e4, and we have the Sicilian defense developing. And then e6, d4, exchanging the pawns, a6, g3, bishop to c5, and exchanging the knights, and then pushing the pawn, and black has a clunky position. As you can see, because of the e-pawn, developing the queen, defending the f-pawn, knight to e7, knight to e4, and targeting the tender square by Steinitz, and black castled, bishop to d3, knight to g6, pushing the pawn, defending the pawn, pushing the pawn, exchanging and pushing the pawn. Well, attacking the knight, Wilhelm Steinitz captured the bishop, queen takes on c5. And queen to c3, not exchanging the queens but capturing back the pawn, queen takes on d6, b3. Well, obviously Wilhelm Steinitz wants to fianchetto his bishop, bishop to b2, and then threatening checkmate, so a5, a3, queen to d5, rook to f1, defending the rook, rook to a7, and bishop to b2. Black is defending with the rook, but once again, but still, this is looking scary for black. c5, and Wilhelm Steinitz castled from the queen side, threatening discover attacks to the queen, queen to c6, h4, advancing from the king side, rook from f to f7, and h5, attacking the knight, knight to e7, bishop to c4, and targeting the tender pawn, the weak looking pawn, knight to d5, attacking the queen, and queen to e5. And in this position, Wilhelm Steinitz is attacking the knight for 3 times. So this is looking dangerous already in this position. And if moving the knight, maybe rook to d8 is on the cards. The open file is also looking vicious for black. And we have queen to c7, offering for exchanging the queens, for trading the queens. And if exchanging the queens, there is nothing special for white. What would you do in this position? If you had the white pieces in this position, well, this is the key moment of this chess game. Can you guess the attacking move of Wilhelm Steinitz? Well, Wilhelm Steinitz captured the knight with the rook, rook takes on d5, and if you see this move, then well done. An exchange sacrifice, but we have e takes on d5. What happens if capturing the queen? Then rook takes on e5, and white is a piece up in a winning position. And black is losing. So in this position, if you see rook takes on d5, then well done. And McDonnell captured the rook. E takes on d5. And what is the follow-up? Well, the follow-up is very simple. Checking the king, attacking the king. Only defense is with the rook. And bishop takes on d5. And where is the king going? We have blocking with the queen. If running away with the king, then capturing the rook. Queen takes on f8. Check, mate. So let's get back to the real game. After bishop takes on d5, McDonnell is losing the queen. And Wilhelm Steinitz simply captured the queen with check. Who rook takes on f7 and defending the queen. Well, they played few more moves and after 8-6, McDonnell resigned. Another exciting chess game by Steinitz. Well, the possible continuation is very simple. If capturing the pawn with the rook, then capturing the pawn with the queen. Check, mate. And if capturing back with the g-pawn, black has a disgusting position. As you can see, this is losing for McDonnell. And this was the attack by Steinitz. Rook takes on d5. And if you see this move, then well done. Everything is collapsing after this position. And McDonnell, after 8-6, he resigned. And let me give you an interesting information about this chess game. After the end of this chess game, Wilhelm Steinitz was a little bit sarcastic about his opponent, I believe. This was the quote of Wilhelm Steinitz. He said, "This player is stronger now than he was when he played Labordonnais." So he was obviously meaning of Alexander McDonnell. Alexander McDonnell was the real McDonnell. He was the strongest player in his era, along with Labordonnais. Actually, he was the second strongest player in that era. And he played many games with Labordonnais. He played this famous match. When told of this to George McDonnell, McDonnell replied that other McDonnell has been living on my reputation ever since he died. So at this time, the real MacDonald, Alexander MacDonald, was not even alive. So Wilhelm Steinitz was probably making fun because of the name resemblance between MacDonald and Alexander MacDonald. Well, Alexander MacDonald played that very famous match with Labordonnais. They played many games, countless of chess games. They were amazing rivals. So that was another MacDonald. Anyway, thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye bye.